Morning, everyone. Welcome back to another ITHVL lesson. Today, we're going to do a new project called Donut Steel, and I assure you it's going to be really fun. Okay, so let's take a look at our schedule first. So this is today's ITHVL lesson schedule. We're going to start with this video, which is the individual learning. So I'm going to go through the project Donut Steel with you. I'm going to show you a video of the gameplay, and then I will go through the game features. Okay, what we need to work the game. Finish on your own. I need you to look at the teacher's demonstration video on how to code the game, and then you will need to do it on your own on Scratch. Finish Donut Steel, go back to eCampus, do your self-checklist, and then that will be the end of ITHVL. Okay, simple. All right, so let's get started. Okay, so our Donut Steel project looks a bit like this. We will have a donut sprite with many hand sprites, as well as a target sprite. Okay, so what you do is you're going to apply some of the previous skills you learned. We're going to learn how to add starting codes or practice that again, how to set your size, how to set your position for your sprites. All these actually you know already, so we're going to practice again. We're going to create a score variable for your game, add sounds, as well as touch sensitive actions. So if something touches something, it's going to result in a different action. Okay. Now, some new things we're going to learn today. We're going to learn how to make an aim and a hit code. So for this, you will need to use both hands on your keyboard. One hand to control the mouse, the other hand to shoot at things. Okay, so we're going to learn and explore this soon. And you're going to make some sprites move in from the edge of your game. Okay, so you're going to make all the hand sprites come in from different edges of the game. Okay, so let's take a look at how it works first. We're going to watch a video, then we'll understand better. Oh no, they stole the donut. Okay, so this is a very fun and simple game. So let's take a look, how does it work? So in this game, the player has to prevent all these hand sprites from touching or stealing the donut. Okay, the hands will move randomly from the edges of the screen, so that has to be coded. Okay, and something special for today's game, how do we stop the hands from catching the donut? We need to do an aim and a hit code. So first, you need to move your target sprite to your hand using your mouse, and you will need to press the spacebar to hit the hands. Okay, very simple. So let's take a look at it in more detail. Okay, so the first feature, like what I mentioned just now, is that we will have an aim and a hit code. So we are going to use our mouse and our keyboard control. Okay, so how does this work? Basically, on your hand sprite, all of them will have this condition. If touching mouse pointer and key space press. So this means that if you aim the target at the hand sprite, you move your mouse to the hand sprite, and at the same time, if you press your spacebar to hit the hand will get shot. Okay, very simple code. So later we'll get to see the full coding and explanation during the teacher's demonstration video. Okay, I'm going to move on to the second feature. Okay, another special thing about this game is that all our hand sprites will move in from the edge of the game screen. Okay, so this is quite interesting. Let's learn how to do the coding for this. Okay. Okay, so I think I went through this in our chicken catch lesson, but let's go through it again. So our scratch screen is this big, okay? The top maximum value is 180 for Y. The bottom minimum value for Y is minus 180, okay? For your right, your maximum right for X is 240. The minimum left for X is minus 240. So if you put your sprites at this position, it will be at the edge of the game. Okay, so let's take a look at the sprites one by one. Okay, we're going to have one hand that comes in from the bottom edge. So for that, what I did was I fixed my Y position. Okay, I fixed my Y position to be minus 180. That's the bottom edge. But I allow my game to choose a random left and right position. Okay, so my hand can come in anywhere, left and right from the bottom. Okay, so it should look something like this. All right, and how we get it to move is to always point it towards the donut and move towards the donut. Okay? Very simple. So we're going to repeat this for all the other hands from different position. Okay? Now let's take a look at the top hand. All right? For the top hand, we're going to fix the top position. Y180. So I fixed it here. And I make my game choose my random left and right position. Okay? Then our hand is also going to point towards the donut and forever move towards it. So it should look like this. Okay, very simple. Moving on. Now, from the right side of the screen, okay, we're going to have a hand coming in from the right. For this, I fix my right position, X, to be 240 over here. But I will let my game choose a random up and down position. My Y is random. Okay? So the hand will move in like that. All right? Now, same for the left edge. Okay, so if it's coming up in from the left, we fix the left position, minus 240, but you let your game choose a random up and down Y. Okay? And then your hand will just move into the donut. All right, so these are all the codes we're going to use today. This is not the full coding. I will show you the full coding in the demonstration video. Okay, so have fun. All right, I'm going to give you a template today. So when you sign in to Scratch using Campus Class, you will see that I've already created a template for each of you. Okay, so in your template, I will give you a stage backdrop of a table, and I'll give you three sprites, a target sprite, a donut, and one hand sprite. Okay, so later, you will need to duplicate your hand to make three other hands. So that should be four hand sprites coming in from different directions. Okay, now if you don't like the sprites that I've given you, you can also be creative. You can change the sprites on your own. Okay, so let me give you some ideas that you can do. If you don't like donuts still, hands, you can make it a diamond still. So maybe put a diamond in the middle instead of the donut. Have people sprites coming in. Okay, so just replace the picture of the sprites. Or you can do a cat and mouse game. So cat catching the mouse replaces the donut. The cat will replace the hand to come in from the edge. Okay, so have fun with this campus. If you don't want to do these other ideas, you can just stick to the donut still idea. Okay, so before we end this video, let me go through some basic expectations. Okay, for your activity today, I need you to go to Scratch, do your donut still. Once you finish, save your work, sign out of Scratch, go back to eCampus and do your self-checklist. Okay, so at least I know whether you understand or don't understand or finish or not finish. All right? Okay, so have fun today. I will see you in another lesson. Bye.